welcome to HeArtfully Creating. Hi, I'm Howard, where Anita HeArtfully created me.
Today's Polymer Clay Journey, we're going to have a PractiCLAY project. And if you have been here before, you know that a PractiCLAY project is a word on practical project with Polymer Clay. So PractiCLAY, get it? We're decorating our new oil bottles. I just thought they looked a little boring by themselves. Now you can use strips or rolled clay, and this is from another tutorial, and piece the letters together if you want to do words on the bottle. Obviously this is not an oil bottle, but I just want to show the technique. So the rolled clay technique, or technique, strips of Primo. I've used Primo because it's strong, and like I said, I always like to mix it. I don't usually use black directly from the package. So yeah, just make sure that your joints are connected. Use a ball tool, silicone tool, but I chose to use the removal technique. So again, this is from a previous tutorial. I just want to show the technique because unfortunately I didn't film because it was too dark when I started, got the idea to do the bottles, or decided to finally do the bottles. So just again, I rolled out a sheet of rectangle clay, laid it on the olive oil and canola bottles, and then I just made sure it was nice and smooth and adhered really well. Now, as you know, if you're working with clay, that it will peel off glass quite easily. That's why you work on ceramic tiles, and for the window clingies, which is, this is the exact same technique, it will peel off, but my goal was to make it not peel off. So I used liquid clay, but I used Kato. I told you I put it in the Sculpey bottle, an empty one, and Adirondack inks I used in this one instance. I added some glow-in-the-dark powder for fun. These little plastic triangle dishes that I bought on eBay, they're neat looking, but they're really annoying to use because I knock them over all the time. They tip over really easy. So I tapped the raw clay for a faux hammered look, making sure everything is good and sealed. This is the canola one, was already cured and baked. That's where I added, I used bottle color and Adirondack ink and clover and kind of mixed it a bit. It was a little more mottled looking. The olive oil one here is just the bottle color. So I'm using a silicone nail tool. It's two-ended, it's double-ended, and my brain isn't really working, so sorry about that. One end is pointy, the other end is like a beveled cylinder. You can get them really pretty cheap, actually, on eBay. I look under free shipping. That's how I get a lot of my stuff I've gotten from eBay, free shipping, and buy now. So then I'll just click and look for what cheap nail art tools I can find, and they work well with polymer clay. Now the number one thing that I learned is do not over flood. In the last couple of months or few months of doing faux stained glass or window clingies, is I have been putting, when I think it needs more liquid clay, I add too much, then it ends up like flooding. That's why it's flooding is a term that's used in cake decorating with I can't remember what it's called, but it's like, I think royal icing, where you make the outline in like a firmer icing and then you flood it. Well, we can't eat this. Please don't eat this. But yeah, you flood it. So don't over flood. It's better to start out with too little than too much. So I push the liquid around gently, touching the edges of, like, until it comes up against the black lines, because you want it sealed. So you just keep doing that. I have this in high speed because I don't want you to be really bored. I think on YouTube you can slow it down if you want. If anybody wants to watch regular speed tutorials, let me know. I assume people, we're living in a McDonald's society. They like things quick and fast. So I personally like a lot of the regular time videos. I'm not a big fan of the high speed ones, but I just want to try to make you guys happy. So let me know what you want to see. Slow, fast, a little medium, I don't know. I just enjoy doing it. So yeah, so just fill until every little part is full. However, like I said, do not over flood or you'll have a mess. And especially these bottles are, the surface is, there's a slight roundness. They're pretty flat, but as you get to the edges, they start to curve just enough. So again, you want to consider that, because then your liquid ink, that's why I didn't, or your, sorry, your liquid clay will flood out and you'll have it raised up too much. That's why I brought the letters and shortened the height of them. I didn't make it go right side to side like I wanted to. So then let it self-level and then add more drops or drips of clay where you need it and just gently touch it and move it around. You don't want it to get messy. it's harder. You could trim it out with a craft knife if it did flood on you, but I would just try to be as neat and minimal as you can. And if you bake it and it turns out like with lots of like blank spots or really thin areas, you might like that look, or you could always add more liquid clay and put it back in the oven. You'll see that's what I did with the canola oil once I got the idea to put the glow-in-the-dark powder, which so far I've asked my husband. He's the one who's up when it's dark. I'm always in bed first, and I haven't heard any word on anything glowing, so maybe it didn't work. I haven't had much success with glow-in-the-dark powders. So I needed some more clay, so I decided to use some clover Adirondack with more Cato clay and mixing it in my really favorite little triangular plastic. Actually, these little triangular plastic dishes from eBay are polymer clay compatible because it doesn't get eaten up, where you have to be careful what kind of plastics you use. Even if you're using something temporary to mix up with some inks to make a mess and you don't want to have to wash it out, you might still want to experiment because it could eat away really quickly. For some reason, don't ask me the science of this, but plastic, polymer clay, if incompatible with certain plastics, will eat away at the plastic. So I've had some great containers, like a Ferrero Rocher chocolate one, which I love, but I foolishly put wet, unbaked Primo clay on it, and overnight, it actually ate into the plastic. Cindy Leitz of the Polymer Clay Tutor has a whole video on explaining what plastics work and what plastics don't and how you can know. So I strongly suggest checking out all of her videos because she's great and she's really good at doing all the work for us lazy people who don't want to have to do all the experimenting because she's waiting months to find out the results for things that we're too impatient for. And then we baked it flat on a pan, just flat on a pan. So this is how it looked, all cured. This is actually in the morning sunlight, so it, of course, gives it a bit of a warmer look. You can carve away excess clay with your craft knife. I did that on some of the letters. And yeah, I just thought it really looked cool. It was a really neat way to decorate bottles. Again, it's a practical or practically project because you can take something for everyday use or in your home or home decor and make it look cool and interesting. So I hope you're inspired to jazz up some bottles. Just make sure there's no oil in it. These were bone dry, never been used. I wouldn't recommend it using it if there's something in it. Wouldn't it be too good? You don't want to put any oil stuff in the oven while you're baking it. And remember, polymer clay is not food safe, so don't eat it or don't let your stuff touch it. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you want to. And if you want to check out our Facebook group, and we also have a Facebook page, just look up a Heartfully Creating on Facebook and you'll see what we have. And then you can join in and be updated of any sneak peeks or behind the scenes stuff before anyone else does. Have a great day.